Welcome to the intro episode of my newest podcast called Weight Loss, as in W-A-I-T loss. Today's episode is really about sharing kind of the idea behind what weight loss is all about. And it's actually an idea that I had, ironically, 5+ years ago, which is the whole idea behind why I'm doing this, because there have been so many things in my life that I've done and accomplished, but there have been many, many things that I've waited around and thought about doing and meant to do, but just never did. So due to some things that happened recently that I want to share with you, I really got my idea and my head in place and, quite frankly, got off my ass and decided to start to do some things that I've been having on the shelf for a while, and I wanted to be able to really launch those. So the best way to start this is the backstory to where why I'm doing this now is that I had what I'm calling a near-life experience. You hear people talk about having a near-death experience. Well, I have had a near-life experience, and it happened about 3 years ago when my sister Kelly and I started spending more time with our dad because he had a stroke, then he had a second stroke, and then he had a third stroke. Luckily, he didn't get any paralysis. But basically what happened was it was vascular dementia. And my sister, who is an RN, said that it's kind of like your brain gets bruised. So with each particular stroke, the further and further he went from knowing my mom and my sister and I and our kids and, you know, really anybody in his life. And so dad was really very, very healthy for most of his life until he had this stroke happen. And the stroke only affected his brain. It didn't affect his overall physicality and what he was doing. And he still was very strong and still very much alive. But what was happening was he was starting to leave the house where he was staying with my mom, and he would just take off, and the police would pick him up, and he became really basically a danger to himself and to others. So what we had to do was get him to a what's called a memory care unit, a place where 24/7 he could be with others that had memory issues and really get a chance to start to, you know, kind of transition into a different way of a lifestyle for him. Unfortunately, what happened was we got into the memory care unit and he was doing okay for a while, but then same way he was at home, he was wanting to leave and he wanted to, you know, exit the unit. And that tension, that stress made it hard on him. And so what ended up happening, my sister and I spent a lot of time with him going back and forth to a couple of hospitals, trying to find some way to medicate him so he could just kind of get balanced with all of that. And unfortunately, long story short, he went downward in a downward spiral to the point where within a short amount of time, basically what had happened was he went into palliative care, then he went into hospice care, and he eventually died on August 1st. Dad was kind of a complete guy. He completed the month of July. He was done, and so he passed away on August 1st. So what I'm about to share with you is that although this may sound a little bit morbid, when I mentioned to you earlier that I had a near-life experience, one of the things that had happened was my sister and I, a few weeks before Dad started really going downhill, we went and met with an amazing funeral director by the name of Kristen, who is one of the co-owners of Panabaker Funeral Home in Hanover. And also she has two amazing people on her team, Joey Lynn and Casey. And they helped us kind of go through the process of literally like learning funeral services 101. We'd never been through this before. And Dad knew that he wanted to be cremated. So we went through the whole process of choosing the casket and doing all of that. And at the time, Kristen had mentioned to us, you know, she said, did you want to be at the cremation of your father? And we're like, my sister and I both are like, no, there's no way in the world that we want to be there. And after we said that, Kristen kind of, in her usual way, she was great at really helping us feel really comfortable about what's going on. She said, well, let me share with you that that actually happens with a lot of people who are there and they go through the cremation process. And we're like, oh, okay, we'll listen. And she said, you know, when people typically get buried and they're in a casket and then you go to the graveyard and then you're lowered down into the ground and you know that they put dirt on top and that's it. Well, in this particular case, instead of going down in the ground, you're basically going horizontal. So what happened was, at first my sister and I really reacted to the place. So like, we just don't want to do that. It just doesn't make any sense for us. But then we kind of, everything we've been doing with our dad over those 3 months was like, what would dad do? Like, that was the kind of thing that we just knew. What would he want? What would he do? And so we decided, well, we don't want to go and see him get cremated, but if it happened where one of us died and they offered that to him, he'd be there. So then we decided, okay, we got to just, you know, put on our big boy pants and we're going to go do that. So it was funny because one of the things that the funeral home did when they heard a lot we were talking about, they gave us this little card that we had at the service that was WWFD. And our dad's name is Forrest. And so we kind of gone by the idea of like, what would Forrest do? So it was really befitting, not only for his services, but it's been really befitting for me almost now, a couple of weeks afterwards. I just, when I'm doing anything now, I'm like thinking about what would dad do? How would he go about it? So my sister and I went to the crematorium. We were there with Kristen. She explained the whole process. There was a room we were in. There was a big glass window. And they opened the curtains, and there's ended up being Kristen and her husband, both owned the funeral home. And there was dad's casket, and there was this enormous big looking machine, a big oven. And ironically, our dad sold machines from Japan and Switzerland and Germany. Like, and it was literally like, this is really unusual. Like, here's this casket, dad's gonna go in this thing, and it like looks like the machines that he had sold. Now, you might be listening to this and you think this is really morbid. I get it. I understand it. But the reason why I'm sharing it with you is that when I said I had a near-life experience, I have been with my father for a very long time, traveling the world. We hunted, we fished, we did business things together. I experienced a lot of life with my dad. And in that moment, I guess we had a lot of time to really kind of look at the transition of how, you know, dad is going downhill, and then palliative care, hospice, and his eventual death, and then obviously the services, which, by the way, I digress, the services were amazing. They were incredible because they were outside, and it was in a beautiful scenery overlooking a pond, and we wanted to do that because dad was an outdoors person, and he lived on a farm, so we wanted him to really have the last part of his life be out in a beautiful setting, and Kristen and her group did an amazing job putting that together. Anyway, what had happened was watching him go into this, where the door opens, you don't see any fire. The casket goes in, they close the door, and they describe, there's like literally like a control panel like dad would have on the machines that he sold. And it kind of told the story and how it worked and what would happen. And all I can tell you was looking at that in that moment, and then the next day my sister and I went to the funeral home and we picked up the box of his ashes. I got really related to, I don't care where I have been in my life and where anyone is in their life, there comes that finality. And there was just something about knowing that there's no longer a literal body around that really had a major impact on my thinking and made me really become very reflective afterwards. And what I really got from this whole process was that our dad was somebody that didn't waste a lot of time thinking and planning. He was really somebody that did things. He was in action. It's not that he didn't have goals. It's not that he didn't really plan. But for the most part, instead of contemplating life, he lived life. He lived life full out. And he just was that way his entire life. So the reason why I wanted to be able to do this podcast and to share this introduction is it's really the backstory. Where for me, you know, sometimes you get these things that happen in your life that really become like a transformative moment or a catalyst for you to make a change. For me, it was profound. And it made me really, I've always been grateful for my life. I've done a lot of things. I really am very happy about what I've done. But you're probably like me. You've done a lot of things and experienced a lot of things in your life. But you probably know in your heart, at least I know in my heart, that I've still really only scratched the surface of what is possible for me to create in my life, what I can create for my friends and family, what I can do as being a contribution to other people. So that's what I got from this experience. And I said, you know what? I've thought about this idea for quite some time. I enjoy doing interviews. I enjoy doing podcasting. I enjoy sharing things with people. And I thought it's time for me to take my idea of weight loss, which is about just letting go of waiting for things to happen, like, you know, the right time, the right amount of money, the right person, the right connection. You know, we can come up with a whole list of things that we want to do. It could be writing a book, starting a business. It could be getting in a relationship. It could be having children. It could be anything. I mean, I'm 63 years young. I've lived a lot of life. I've done a lot of things. I've been extremely successful. I've also had some like roller coaster failures that are just like crazy. And what I've done though is I've really, against all odds, I've kind of hung in there and I've experienced a lot of things. So what you can expect in these future podcasts is that I'm going to be interviewing what I call weight loss thought leaders and change agents, people that really are amazing at just getting things done, moving beyond procrastination, moving beyond perfection, making things happen. So I want to do those interviews and really get people to share what they've done for that. I'm also going to share stories of people that have overcome their own weight loss and their experiences and the way that they've created their lives and how they're living them. And if you follow me at all, you know that kind of my North Star, what I do now and what I love to do is I'm really committed to creating a life I love and living it well. And I'm committed to doing that for everyone. And what I mean by creating a life that I love and living it well is I want you to be able to do something that you really love and are passionate about and something that really lights you up and excites you. And living well is more than just what you weigh or what your health is. It's like what I call your well-being. It's your whole self. It's the part of you that is really kind of holistically what has you wired, what has you be a contribution to yourself, to the people that you love in your life, to your community. So one of the things that I'm going to do is I've shared this picture a few times on some of my social media. This is a picture of my dad and I when we lived in Towson at the time in a row house. And I love this picture because it looks like a Norman Rockwell photograph or a painting. And it's funny because that's my dad sitting there holding a paper. He was an avid reader. Even when his dementia was really bothering him, he was just voracious at reading or seeing things. And there he is with a newspaper. And I'm always reading things. I'm always on the newspaper. I love all of that. But one of the things that I waited too long for was I wanted to be able to, and I did this about 10 years ago. I sat down and I composed this idea where I said to my dad, I said, you know, I would love to work with you to write a book about your life as being a boy on the farm, because my dad's first 18 years of his life was really living on a farm. And as he got older, he became a machinist, and then he became a salesman, and he traveled the world. He was doing business all over Europe. He's doing business in Thailand. He was on safari in South Africa. Here was this guy that was a farm boy from Western Maryland, high school education, but he was a brilliant man in what he did and how he lived life. And the working title I have for the book was called Farm Boy. Farm Boy, and basically it was about soil, sweat, and soul. So I had this idea, and it was really a great idea, but I've had a lot of ideas, and maybe you have too, but I never did the idea. It literally sat on the shelf. It never happened. He's gone. I can't recreate that book, not in the way that I wanted to. So I can't make that come back. But one of the things that I really wanted to be able to do was I'm going to write a book called Weight Loss. And a lot of that's going to come out of the podcast that I'm doing, the interviews that I have. The front cover is going to be Dad and I on the front cover, not because I'm writing the story of Dad and I. There'll be a piece in there, an introduction that kind of tells a backstory of where this came from. But what I see as an opportunity is I get to talk to people all the time. And I got to talk to a lot of people in Dad's whole process, people that were older, people that kind of were on the tail end of their life. And the last thing I want for myself or people that I love or people that I can reach out to and support, I really would love to have people not have any regrets. And that's, I know you can't do that completely, but I would rather have people have lived a life where instead of them talking and dreaming and, you know, having great intentions about things that they wanted to do on their life, I would rather have them be able to literally create those things. So that's the spirit behind weight loss together. We can explore that. I want to be able to share stories of people that are doing that. I want to be inspired. I want to be able to inspire others to do the same thing. I just think that when you look at life, there are a lot of challenges. Like, we're all going through those challenges right now. It's a challenging time, and we're not anywhere close to probably being any easier for quite a while. Who knows, maybe the rest of the year, maybe even the next year. But there is an opportunity now for us to step back and to look at, what is that thing that maybe we've had on the shelf? What would it take to write the book? What would it take to maybe create something we talked about? Maybe it's a conversation. Maybe it's something you want to clean up in your life. Maybe it's a journey you want to go on, something you want to do, a trip. I don't know what that is. But I think the spirit of really getting people to look at their life as an opportunity, not right or wrong, not perfect, but just being more engaged and alive and out there and creating things that are in their heart and soul. That's the spirit behind weight loss. So thank you for your generosity of time today, for being here. As you can see, I didn't have some special opening. I don't have some special closing. This is just literally a stake in the ground to share really a way for me to honor Dad's life, and quite frankly, the life of all of us, as an opportunity for us to really tap into whatever is really we're passionate about and something that we want to share with other people. So as always, I love to hear your thoughts about what I've shared today, maybe how it served you. If there's a topic you'd like me to talk about, please let me know. I mean, as I think you can see, weight loss is about literally life. Everything in our life, from our career to our family to relationships with our spouse, partners, children, you name it. There's something here that probably we've been waiting to do, and there's an opportunity for us to move beyond that and to do something that really will light us up and light others up in contribution for their lives as well. So thank you for today, and I will be back many, many times sharing with you more and more ideas around weight loss and how that can serve you. Thanks a lot. Till we see each other again.